Hello everyone and welcome to the first episode of Let's Play Total War Warhammer. In this episode we'll be starting out with the Chaos Warriors. Sort of a summary of the Total War games, they are a part turn-based strategy, part real-time. It has a campaign map with that's turn-based similar to the Civilization series, but the battles are done in real time. So let's get started and hope you enjoy. Alright, so in Total War Warhammer, you have the option of several heroes you can start with. You have Archaon, the Ever Chosen. He's the faction leader for the Chaos Warriors. You also have Kolek Sun Eater. He's a dragon ogre. Pretty much a gigantic monster. And then we also have Prince Sigvald the Magnificent. He's a powerful melee fighter and leader. So for this episode, I'm going to go with Prince Sigvald. And we'll see how well he does. So let's get started.
The old world is weak. The mortal nations flounder in their own incessant and petty wars. Ignorant of what truly awaits in the north. I come before the mighty Archaon as a mere minion. For now, at least, the god's favored champion chooses to hear my advice. I pray to the dark powers that I do not fail him. Despite such a risk, I urge my master that now is the time to march south. The Northmen grow restless. We must harness that and send the tribes in a great tide southwards to flood the old world. Archaon himself, chosen of the gods, will lead the hordes of chaos as we despoil the lands of men and dwarfs. No soul, no matter how blackened or pure, shall see salvation.
Your adopted father calls you, Sigvald. The Dark Prince desires destruction and perversion of the world. Let it begin. You shall go into the lands of the mortals to spread fear and destruction. The Norse tribes to the west shall fall easily before you. Bind those willing to join your cause and slay the rest. Further to the south lie the nations of men. They will resist your advance, and for good reason. You will bring them annihilation, mighty lord. Devour the mortal souls to bring the favor of the Chaos Gods. March forth and spread oblivion in their name.
Alright, so this is our first objective. All are pawns of chaos. All must serve. Do as the Dark Gods wish and begin the destruction. Thus is the way prepared for the end times. So for this we pretty much have to razor sack 4 different settlements. We have a few already out close by that we can see. We got Barsonling. Yeah, that's, I'm not gonna be able to pronounce that. Yeah, this dude's camp. What else do we have nearby? Okay, that looks like the only one that we can see immediately in our field of vision. So as starting out, each of the factions in Total War Warhammer have different sort of setups. For the Chaos Warriors, they're pretty much a roaming.
God.
a roaming horde. And this pretty much this means is that they set up little encampments. So in the little selection over here, you can change his stance to channeling, encamp, raiding, and march. So since we want to build up his forces a little bit, we'll put him on the encamp stance. And I think he actually automatically does that if you actually go to recruit units, but whatever. So, and to start out, let's recruit just some basic marauders just as a fodder to die. So that's pretty much all we're going to be able to do in this start of, well, we got a few other things we can do for this turn. In the technology area, well, this is the automatic starter, so we'll start that off. And then I'll open up a few other options along the way. Other than that, well, we can update our camp as well. So when you're set up as encamped, you have your army panel, which shows the units that you have in your selection. And then there's the building panel. Now, most of the time when you're in a settlement for the other factions, this is where you'll have the buildings. In this case, the buildings follow you along. So it looks like the only option we have to upgrade is set up a tribal gathering, an upgrade to our nomadic camp. So it'll take 1600 gold or favor, as it's called, for the chaos people. And yeah, so let's do that. And that looks like that's about it that we can do for this turn. So we'll go down here, we'll end the turn, and see what happens next. Alright, so we have a little message. Winds of magic change. The fickle winds of magic spill from the realm of chaos and flow across the world. The winds wax and wane in an incomprehensible fashion, at times blowing a gale, while in other places becalmed. Now the arcane currents have changed once again. The stronger the winds are blowing in a region, the faster they will replenish in battles fought there, and vice versa. This affects how many spells can be cast over the course of a battle. So pretty much this affects your caster units. Right now, I don't happen to have any. I can't even recruit any sorcerers right now, because I don't have the proper setup in my camp. I can recruit that, but I don't really want to right now. I can also construct some different things too, but I don't want to do that right now either. So, actually, I want to build up my horde a little bit more before I attack this first settlement. So let's get a couple Marauder Horsemen. They're ranged units, so they can help a little bit in the battle to come. Okay, so these don't cost any gold. So we have income from sacking settlements. Skulls for the Skull Throne to increase post-battle loot and reduce recruitment costs. So I think I'll do that one for the time being to reduce our recruitment costs, because after we attack this, we're probably going to lose some units. Since we're recruiting, we can't move. So I think that is going to end our next turn here. Our sort of overall goal that I'm going for right now is to build up the horde. That way it gives us enough units to attack this settlement pretty effectively. And then we'll move on from there to recruiting new lords and that sort of thing. A few options around here, but I don't have the money for it. And Archaon doesn't become open until, let's see, I have to slaughter 10 sets of captives after a battle. So, got a little bit to go for that one. So let's end our turn. And right now we're at 17. I'll spend one more turn recruiting, and then in the next turn I will head towards this camp here to attack. All right, so when you're in the encampment stance, you can't move, so you do have to change it back. In this instance, do we want to... Let's just do normal, no stance. And then we'll move down to here. And that's about as far as we can move, so we'll end the turn. Alright, now if I wanted to, I could change my stance to raiding, which would increase income. It looks like it would give me a 267, but right now I'm just looking to take out this encampment, so I'm just going to attack.
Unleash chaos! Ravage them!
Alright, we have a few options, but I just want to take them out now, so I'm actually going to just fight the battle. Alright, starting now, I am going to actually set up my forces a little bit. I think I'm going to have most of my melee units sort of towards the front, have my ranged off to the side, and then I'll have my warhounds sort of separate, since they're quick and easy at taking down enemies that route. So let's get everything set up, and then I'll start the battle. And with every battle, right before it starts, you actually have the options to set up the location of all the units. But yeah, I think we'll do all right. We pretty much outnumber all of them.
The maps available to assist your tactical planning, Commander.
And we do have our Hell Cannon here. Oh, hey, that's kind of neat. Alright, had to change something up real quick there, because the key I was using for push to talk was actually insert, which is what's used for manual fire mode here, so. Didn't want anything to get more messed up than it already could be. Alright, gonna speed up my forces a little bit here as they approach. Get them ready to take out these guys, and we'll definitely be all set.
Your troops will fire at will without orders to the contrary, Commander. Have them conserve their ammunition, if you so wish. Group your units for best effect, Commander. Formations may be useful when maneuvering before the enemy.
All right, now that the battle's actually started, I'll slow it down a little bit. I'm going to try to attack these cavalry with my dogs. They can be pretty quick, but I don't know if they're quicker than a horse.
Your troops come under fire, Commander. Have them find cover or eliminate the source.
Okay, it didn't look like the horse. The Chaos Warhounds work pretty good against the horses, so I'll send them against the infantry instead. And here's a personal view from our hero. Now it looks like he really doesn't need the help, but I'm sending him a little help anyways.
The enemy general is slain, my lord, cursing your name with his dying breath. Send his army after him.
And as you can see here, the war dogs are awesome at killing routine infantry. And I just want to kill these guys because I'm a vengeful, yeah.
We'll be back.
Yeah, no you won't. That was enjoyable. Okay, we can end the battle now. I think we have this one dude who's running over here. Yeah, he's just, nah. Alright, we have a few options here for the camp. We can sack the settlement, which gives us a plunder and causes some instability. We can raise it, which would destroy the enemies. Destroying their enemies has strengthened this horde. It gives a boost to our horde, which might be a good thing. or we can awaken the tribe, which turns them into an ally. In this instance, though, I think I'm just going to raise it. So, goodbye, little camp. And it looks like we've gotten a follower for our lord, a beast tamer. Gives experience to war beast recruits. Interesting.
I am Slanesh's scion. Witness my beauty.
All right, we have a few options for updating our hero here. He has the Eye of the Gods perk, which gives weapon strength when attacking. Interesting. Dominating presence increases his leadership aura. Or the Rout Marcher, which is good for campaign mode, which increases his movement range. But I think I want to have him be pretty decent in combat, so we'll give him the Eye of the Gods perk. And with that, we can accept it and end our turn. And as you can see here, the little camp is in ruins. Doesn't do any good for anyone. And we can move on a little bit.
Move.
And set up another encampment.
Shall we decant the wine?
Looking through here to come up with any ideas for possible new buildings, I think I am going to actually upgrade that. And as soon as that is done upgrading, I think I'm going to do this Arcane Vortex, which unlocks Chaos Sorcerers and all that. So that should be an interesting addition to our horde.
I'll move, I suppose.
All right. Since we've moved on to the area around this frozen landing, I'm actually, well, I don't have enough points to go into raiding stance yet. So I'll wait for the next turn, and then I will enter that stance so that we can get a little bit of extra income. And it'll also cause some negative damage to these guys, too. Or negative perks. Though then again, it might not, because they're sort of related to chaos and all that.
Yes. The gods direct me.
All right, we have a little event here. The Chaos Gods take notice of their champion, but rarely do they act in accord. Khorne demands slaughter and Zinch? I've never been good at pronouncing it. Or does a more subtle approach? So we can go for the Blood God. Kill, maim, burn. And follow Khorne, which increases melee attacks for 6 turns. It's not bad. Or we can take the Changer's Way. It decreases hero action costs and hero increases hero action success chance. This is interesting, but for the moment, I think I'm going to go for the Blood God, since we might attack this next settlement here. And I don't have enough. So, looks like I'm going to upgrade to this Trial Pits next, which puts us back into encamp mode. And then after that, we should be able to get some better units, which are more upgraded versions of what we have now. Alright, we have a few options open now. We have Chaos Marauders with the Great Weapons. Gives them a bit boost to they're not exactly boosted, but they have... it's not character details. Well, as you can see, they have a little icon next to weapon strength. I believe that relates to their armor piercing. These dudes. Let's see. I'm trying to decide how I want to set this up. Actually, I think I'll leave my group as it kind of is for the moment. Actually, I'll get rid of a couple warhounds to replace them with poison warhounds. And then in the next turn, I think I'll attack Frozen Landing.
A strategic overview can be useful in such uncertain times, Sire.
Unleash chaos! Do not fail me! Marauder Horseman! Yes?
Norsa!
Mortal fool!
Norsa!
Marauder Horseman!
Oh yeah, another thing I noticed. I don't know if it's because they're cavalry, or... I forgot what's the thing that does it. Let's see. Vanguard deployment. There it is. So because these Marauder Horsemen have the Vanguard deployment sort of perk, they can actually deploy outside the regular zone as far as up to here. So that can give them a bit of a rating boost versus other units. Get them all set up to attack. Alright, let's get started and see what we can do to defeat these guys.
Approach on mounts, Commander. Keep your vulnerable units close at hand.
Ooh, these are nasty looking things, aren't they? Another victory. It's kind of sad, almost. But these little Chaos Tribes really don't present much of a challenge at this point in the game. It is rather satisfying seeing these guys get eaten up. Alright, so let's end this and move on to the next battle. Interesting. Nurgle's champions spread their pestilence to your legions. Those that survive such a blessing will be gifted. We have blessings of the Magoth Lords. It increases melee attack but decreases horde growth. That kinda sucks, but it might be good to prompt us for another attack against the enemy.
Moving! I'll move, I suppose.
Alright, and close by we have the army of Sirtha Ek from Varg, which is that one place we destroyed earlier. And I think he may very well attack us soon. So let's see what happens on the next turn.
Dwarfs, my lord. These runts rarely emerge from under their mountains. Don't be fooled by their stunted height. They are hardy, stubborn creatures, and are not to be underestimated in battle.
Kill them all!
Another event. This settlement offends our masters. Steal what you can and then bring fire to all. Volksgrad. It's down here. It's not too far away. I think we should be able to take it out.
A simpering decision. No. Attack!
The Empire and Stirland have formed a confederation. Through shrewd diplomacy or perhaps outright intimidation, the Empire has convinced Stirland to join them. Well, we're not really worried about the Empire at the moment. Alright, this group I think is from the Empire, or an Empire race of man, or whatever. So, let's take them out, because, yeah. Kill all of the men. Even though we're men ourselves, sorta.
Attend me! They will succumb! Mortal. To the Chaos Gods! Marauder Horsemen! Very well!
Them off.
Slay them. Slaughter all of them.
And here goes Prince Sigvald to join the battle with his warhounds and all his other dudes.
Slanish's scion. Avert your eyes.
Success! Yay!
For chaos! The gods direct me!
Power comes to parley, demanding a change in your mutual relations. Consider their offer carefully.
All right, so let's see. Are these people worthy of joining us? Well, I suppose we could give them a chance. It's only 130 favor, which is like nothing. So, I suppose we can give them a chance to survive. Gives us one less person to have to hunt down. But for the moment, we're going to head over to take out Krakadrek from these dwarves or whatever.
Witness my beauty.
I advise you to seek ways to further your methods of war.
Oh, yes, yes, I know.
Put your best minds to work improving your knowledge and practices.
Let us go!
Who are these grotesqueries?
What is thy will?
The hero has enrolled in your service, sire. Such operatives can solve problems that no amount of money or effort would otherwise be able to crack.
All right. So we have a chaos sorcerer joining our ranks now. They have different abilities, but I think I'm going to make use of him in battle. So I do need to get rid of one group of dudes. Let's get rid of this set of hounds.
Dominance.
Click the sorcerer, click and embed hero.
Chaos. It's mine.
Maybe.
I am Slanesh's sire.
Or maybe he can't move this turn.
True chaos awaits.
There we go.
Go now.
Despoilers come.
Oh, I didn't mean to send him away, but whatever.
Moving, father!
Are you a god?
Attack! Invade!
The enemy city is fortified, my lord. Weapons will be needed to bring down the walls. Prepare your warriors for a long siege.
All right, this is going to be interesting because they are, well, they have a lot of people here. And I don't exactly. So, for the moment, I think I'm going to break the siege. I think I'm going to need a little bit of help on this one.
You dare.
Move.
Oh, the enemy of chaos is near. Hunt down his army and take his head before his troops. Their sorrow will be drank by Slanesh. So that is the dude that is located out. So that's the dude that's located here, that dwarf guy. But before I can attack him, I'm going to want to build up my forces. Actually build up a second horde, because that's probably what I need more than anything. And to do that, I will need another lord. Ooh, another one. The champions of the dark gods are many. One comes to us, ready to serve so he may be rewarded and elevated. Use him, but make sure he knows his place and the consequences of failure. An exalted hero.
Bring ruin.
despoilers come. Very well, I'll move.
Okay, as you can see here, our forces are taking attrition damage. That's due to infighting from the Chaos units. Now we can get rid of that by setting them in the encamp stance, I think. Let's see. Or did I actually misread that? Oh, immune to attrition excludes horde infighting. So they actually do still infight. So whenever two Chaos Lords are close to each other, they take attrition, which damages their troops and all that. So when I get to the next... So it looks like whenever they're in the same province is when that infighting happens. So on the next one, I'll have to build up his forces. And then when... once my Chaos Death Sorcerer's Lord dude, whatever he's called, Ragnar, I'll just call him Ragnar. When his forces are built up, I'll have them join forces to go and attack. But for the time being, let's end turn. Alright, we have another peace treaty offer, though they want a whole lot more this time. 2340. Now, I might have that, but I'm not going to give that, so screw you, Varg. Blood of the Dwarf Lord. This Dwarf Lord has the blood of the hated god Grimnir coursing through his veins. Cut him open and imbibe his life force, for the favor of the ruinous powers awaits. Blech. So I have to carry out a successful assassination attempt on him to get the Wand of Jets. Interesting. Another event. Khorne is not always a bloodthirsty killer. He occasionally recognizes and respects martial prowess in his opponents. He sees it on one of our foes. Human conflict. Your warriors are troubled when doing battle with men. So that reduces our leadership against the humans. So I think that suggests that we shouldn't attack the humans for the time being. blood sacrifice. The ruinous powers demand a large sacrifice of blood. The altars must be drenched in it, or we will suffer a loss of favor. The ruinous powers demand a large sacrifice of blood. We have leadership plus 8. Income from sacking is down. Melee attack is up. Income from horde buildings and post-battle loot is down. And it looks like our Chaos Sorcerer has a boost to him. So we can give him the Fireball spell. Yay! And that should... let's see. So it's pretty much like a magic missile. Does damage, powerful explosion, strong versus multiple combatants. Should definitely help out a little bit.
Enemy power has sent a hero to disrupt the running of your domain. This act of aggression cannot be left unanswered.
Failed. Oh, but I failed this mission. The favor of the Chaos Gods is fickle. No lord or even the ever-chosen remain in the eyes of the dark powers forever. There are always others who aspire to take your place, and they plot and scheme to overthrow you at every opportunity. We have reduced horde growth. We wounded him. Another mission. This bearded mortal is a threat to our plan. Send the oath-shackled fool to an early grave and take his soul for good measure. Oh, it's that dude I tried to assassinate earlier. Alright, I have my horde set up to their maximum size. With any luck, I can begin an assault and take Crack-a-Drack.
Dominance. Bring them to ruin.
Hail the slaughterer!
It is corrupt. Cease. Bring ruin. Never stop!
Don't think so. Destroy! Unleash chaos!
Dwarf throng, come, slaughter them all. Defeat the following lord's army in battle. Well, that happens to be the one I am right outside of. So that should happen right about now.
Wipe them out.
As you can see, the attrition does hurt, though. But I believe we are ready to attack. We have one battering ram and one siege tower. With our forces together, hopefully we can take it.
The siege weapons are ready, my lord. Deploy them against the enemy so we can see them in action.
Weaklings! Slanish his perverse glory!
Season.
Tremble, mortals! Chaos warriors! Finch's many glories! Chaos sorcerer! Name your demand! What do the gods desire?
Alright, so there's options to increase the winds of magic, but right now I think I'm just gonna leave it like that. Because I'm not entirely sure how the gamble mechanic works. You can risk magic for more favorable winds. I think it has to do with the recharge rate, maybe? Something like that. Oh. But, Yeah, this is actually my first siege that I've ever done. So hopefully it goes well. Here we go.
Are in position, my lord, chaos, and are ready to begin their assault. Begin your advance.
Please don't hit my siege tower cannon, dude.
I bring a tempest. I am the god.
Marauder horsemen!
Send troops to capture the enemy defenses, Commander. They can be turned to our service.
And here go our chosen to attack.
Marauder horsemen!
back! Destroy!
Look at all of that.
It all.
Damnation awaits!
Alright, I just gotta get rid of these guys here, and we should have this battle pretty much all wrapped up.
Attend, summoners!
My dark prince
comes! Do not shame your ancestors!
All will be despoiled!
That way!
Chaos, sorcerer!
Torment awaits!
For his manifest glory!
Quickly!
All right, there we go. They're all fleeing. Kill as many as possible. And then we'll end the battle. Definitely a bit of a costly victory, but a lot of loot from it. Alright, with taking out Krek-a-Drek, I am going to end this episode. Definitely was interesting. I think it's an interesting start to our whole fun and excitement. And hope to see you in the next one. Enjoy.